Hello everyone, and in this video I will be showing you Rancher 2.5 on Civo cloud. We'll be going through some of the latest features of Rancher 2.5, and we'll be installing Rancher from Civo's marketplace. So let's get started. First, you log into the Civo cloud console, and when you log in, you will see the dashboard, and you can go to Kubernetes and you can click on create cluster and then type in maybe Rancher and then select the cluster size. Now there's a section called marketplace, and in the management section you can see Rancher is there, so select that and create the cluster. Now this new cluster creation, although it's quick, but it'll take time, so I already have a cluster created for you, which is, let's go back, so it is test Rancher 2.5. Now, once the cluster is created and you have the application installed, there is some additional step which is called post installation. So this step has to be applied onto the cluster. So now what we'll be doing is our Rancher is already installed on our Civo cluster. So we'll be going to the command line and we'll be applying this ingress, and we will start with this. Now I will just switch the screens and I will share my terminal window, and you can see a kubectl get nodes. So our cluster is up and running. So we'll apply that ingress, the post install step for Rancher, but we can access that. Kubectl apply hyphen f Rancher ingress YAML. Ingress is created. Kubectl hit pods just for the confirmation that Rancher is running. Yes, our Rancher is running. Now I'll again switch back and share the screen, so because we want to access the Rancher UI now. So let's go, and for the access we have to copy this. So it's just proceed, and here we go. So you can see with one click install, you are able to get Rancher 2.5. So let's type in any password. And I want to create or manage multiple clusters. I'll do that. Click continue. Rancher server URL is the same URL. So basically, Rancher is a single control plane, or basically Kubernetes control plane, or not the exact Kubernetes control plane, but it is the management plane that helps you run and manage your existing or new Kubernetes clusters. So you can create new Kubernetes clusters from Rancher, you can import the existing clusters to Rancher, and you can manage them, you can install different applications, native applications, monitoring, Rancher backups, so all those things that you can readily do from Rancher UI, the dashboard itself. You can deploy the pods, the services, the applications from their catalogs as well. All those things you can do with Rancher. So this is in short, very brief summary of what Rancher, what all things you can do. And you can monitor your existing cluster, and you can create different distribution clusters as well. Like you can create on different cloud vendors, or you can create a RKE, which is Rancher Kubernetes Engine cluster as well from Rancher UI. So as you can see on the screen, you have what's new in 2.5. You have a new cluster explorer, so which is new kind of a UI, new visualization. Monitoring and alerting will be powered as an operator. We'll dive into that. CIS scans powered by Kubebench is only for actually the RKE clusters, but they have the extended support to perform on EKS and GKE platforms. Then Istio 1.7, you can have installed that and allows users to deploy multiple ingress and egress gateways. Now, this one is super interesting, which is Rancher Continuous Delivery powered by Fleet. So basically, you can have a fleet of clusters and you can deploy an application based on the labels onto the clusters. So basically, you have say that you have 10,000 clusters or just 1,000 clusters and you want to install a single app on all the clusters. So that can be done using continuous delivery, which is a new feature. So we'll not dive into all of them. I'll just give a brief overview of how it looks like. So as you can see, when we have have the Rancher dashboard, it already has a cluster called local, which is the current cluster, the current Civo managed K3s cluster. So you can see a 3-node cluster is there. K3s is the provider, automatically picked up. Now this is the new Explorer that has just been released in 2.5. So you can see the version of Kubernetes running, the total number of nodes, how many total resources are there, the pod reserved, cores reserved, memory reserved, and memory used. You have the event section. And on the left-hand side, if you see, I'll just zoom in a bit. So you can see all your workloads, like if any cron jobs, deployments, pods are there. Now, if you want to create those, so let's go to the deployment. And you can create it from the UI itself. Now, from the UI, you have a lot of options that you can use. So test deployment, and you can have the Nginx latest image and image pull policy. You can add ports like HTTP, name of the port, and you can give 80. Any commands and environment variables, etc., that you can give, and you can click create. Another option is, if you see this little icon, you can create it from a YAML. So if you don't want to have the UI and you like to have YAML instead, so it gives you a basic structure of YAML and you can just edit the YAML and apply that. Or you can read from a YAML as well. So if you have a YAML and you want to read it, so you can do that. So now you can see we have one deployment which is active. It is test. So it is the pod. Pod is running. Very simple for the developer workflow. Also, if you want to have a shell access, you can have a shell access from here. So no need for going to the CLI now. So if I have to deploy get resources, I can directly do from the kubectl shell. So kubectl get pods hyphen a. So you can see I'm able to run all the kubectl commands as well. Another thing is all the storage and the RBAC. So it has a native RBAC support. So what that means is you can actually create the roles just like any other Kubernetes object. You can also create the roles. You can see the roles, role bindings that are there, and you can have a deeper insight of what is happening within your cluster and what all roles have what all permissions. Next is you have little more resources that you can use, like what all API services are getting used. And this is some fleet concepts over there. RBAC, again, the scheduling. Now, if we click on this arrow, and you have two other options. So apps and marketplace is the place where you can actually deploy the applications which are partnered with Rancher very easily. And continuous delivery is the section where you create your fleet, and basically where you create your cluster groups and you deploy the application onto the cluster groups from the GitHub. So you can think of it as GitOps. So you will be able to do GitOps and apply onto all your clusters which are there in the cluster group. Now let's go back to the cluster manager, and you can see we have our cluster over here. Now if we go directly inside the cluster, now you can see a basic view here as well. You can enable and see the live metrics. So earlier, this particular monitoring was the only thing, but now it's deprecated in 2.5, and updated version of monitoring is here, which is the operator, rancher monitoring, basically a complete stack. So it is the Prometheus operator and some other charts as well. So just a brief, not brief, a detailed description of what it will do, and you just click on install. And you can see as well, all these things that are getting installed onto the clusters. So there are jobs that are active, CRDs are getting created, and it is a success. So let's again go back to the cluster manager. Obviously the pods might be coming up, which will take a little bit time. In the meanwhile, I'll show you another thing, which is called the tool section. So in the tool section, you can set up alerts. You can have your logging as well enabled, and you can have your Istio installation. So this is a complete Istio installation. And for the most latest version, obviously you have to, again, it'll be redirected to the newer UI. And from there, you will be able to select all the options, the components, if you want to change the values file, and then you click on install. Now we'll not do that. So let's go to back to the cluster manager. And what I want to show you is there are two more things, which is called Rancher Backups and OPA Gatekeeper. So Rancher natively has OPA Gatekeeper support as well. You can directly install the OPA Gatekeeper from Rancher UI itself. So just directly install, and after that you can have your policies applied onto your cluster. So there is very good user management that you will be able to do when you have Rancher in place. So you have something called members. Now you'll be adding the member over here. You have something called projects and the namespaces. And if we go to members, we can give them custom permissions. So different members can have different permission based on their roles in the organization. Also, if we go back to global, and if we go back to security settings, we can create users, we can create roles, and we can add a global role, we can add cluster wide role, we can add a project wide role as well. So basically in say a dev and in a particular project, they can only list the deployments. We can do that. So that's it. That's how you create a role, and you can attach this role to a user, and you can add that user to a cluster. So that particular cluster, when that particular user logs in, he will be able to see the cluster, but only the deployments of that cluster, nothing else. So that's pretty much it. I mean, obviously that's not it, because it has lots and lots of features that Rancher is having, but what we will be doing next is we can see, yeah, we'll go back to the Cluster Explorer actually. So this is the new dashboard. Now you can see when we have deployed the application, so you can see the cores reserved have increased, the memory reserved have increased, and the core used have also increased, and you can see the memory also is getting used because we have deployed a full-fledged monitoring solution. And you can see the number of pods also must have increased. So we'll give all namespaces over here so that we have list of all the yes. So now you can see there are around 39 pods. And you can see the gate. Yeah, we also installed the gatekeeper. So I forgot. So gatekeeper is also installed. You have full monitoring system activated for the cluster, and everything is ready. And if we go to, yeah, this is the monitoring namespace. Now here is the dashboards. So if we come to the monitoring overview, you can have your Prometheus rules that you can set, alert manager, you can set different rules. And this is the Grafana home that has been set up for the cluster, where you can see all the cluster metrics, API metrics, and the node metrics from there. And these are the service monitors that are running. Let me give it a refresh. And this is the gatekeeper. So as of now, you don't have any constraints and we haven't created anything, but you can have the templates created and the constraints created, which will be applied onto the cluster. PromQL graph, I'll open that as well, and I'll open the alert manager itself. So this is the alert manager. You can have different alerts and see them. And this is the Prometheus. So if you directly want to use PromQL to query the metrics, you can use that. So you can have the metrics will appear. Somehow the Grafana dashboard is not loading. I will click again. And we'll just see. So basically that's how simple it is. You just create the cluster, and while creating the cluster, you can add the application. Or if you want to install the application after the cluster is created, then also it's the procedure is same. You come to the UI, you select whatever application you have to install, you click the application, and then you click on install apps. As simple as that. Yeah, so welcome to Grafana. Grafana has opened. Due to some reason, it was not opening immediately, but now it is open. So you can see, I'll just zoom in some of the graphs so that the data is much more. So you have the API server data, all the pre-built graphs are there. And if I click on the dashboards, these are all the dashboards that are there. So you can have your networking pods, you can have the API server metrics, the cluster metrics, the node metrics. So all those metrics are there. So since this is the new cluster and it's newly, so if I expand, you can see all the metrics. So that's how easy it is to run everything from Rancher. And just one last thing that I want to tell. If you want to create or add new cluster, you just do a add cluster. In that, you can import an existing cluster. So register an existing cluster. So click on other cluster, just name it as test, and just click on create. And we have to run this particular command onto that cluster. So that cluster gets imported to this particular cluster. And if you want to create on any other provider, that also you can do. If you want to create a new Kubernetes cluster on existing node, this will be the RKE that will be installed onto that particular node. So that's it for this video. Hope you like it. Thank you.